If you look at this new agreement, social, environmental, employment standards, they've been put into a non-binding political declaration. So that is quite disappointing from a citizen, from a worker's perspective here for the EU. These are cheap declarations on the one hand, but what we really want now is that the rights of workers, the social rights, the ecological standards will be respected in any future relationship. It might not. Many things have been said on both sides, so I'm not going to take anyone's word for it, definitely not Juncker's. We'll see what happens. What I'm concerned with right now is this self-congratulatory nature of all these statements from Barnier, from Juncker. You know, if I'm looking at it like as a European citizen, as a European worker, I want to make sure that what's going to happen, be it Saturday, be it in a year, is not going to harm both our workers, our economy, and our social rights. And this is not guaranteed right now. So this is something I would expect. You know, if they're serious about saying, okay, citizens should be central to this, why are they waiting to lift austerity? I've never heard Barnier made a statement against austerity. Well, this is hurting our people. We know Brexit, in whatever form, will have a social and economic impact on all citizens in Europe and in the United Kingdom. So in that case, let's lift austerity. Let's invest publicly in social services, in our economy, which is going to suffer and which is already in crisis. So, you know, for me to take them seriously, they'd have to promise some concrete advances for our people. Well, I mean, I think we can fight austerity with the British workers and with the British trade unions as well. I don't think austerity is linked as such, is caused by Brexit. I think austerity has been a policy that has also, by the way, been initiated in the UK. Margaret Thatcher, may I remind you, and then also obviously afterwards, Tony Blair, they have implemented austerity policy. So it's not a European Union issue, but it is very much an issue of class, of working people that are made to pay for a crisis they didn't cause. And so in this sense, what I really want is some self-criticism, because to all those workers in Britain that said, we don't want austerity anymore, we're sick and tired of seeing our NHS destroyed, the European Union has not offered a credible alternative socially. So we need some self-criticism here from the leaders, from the European establishment, to say, okay, the European Union is not a social Europe right now, and this is what we're going to fight for.